Hello today, I welcome the audience. My guest today is Professor Schoop, and today we want to explain our VCL framework to our partners regarding the ValueX project. But what does ValueX mean? It's about virtual Albanian European universities exchange and addresses three points. At first, the qualification of academic staff at Albanian higher education institutions on modern pedagogical and didactical methodologies for innovative virtual teaching and learning settings. Also, we want to support Albanian higher education institutes in adopting and implementing effective ICT-based internationalization for at-home activities and integrate Albanian higher education institutes in a global network for virtual mobility. The third point is the qualification of administrative staff at Albanian higher education institutes in adopting virtual and blended mobility as part of their institutional internationalization strategy. So, Professor Schoop, you use the VCL as a framework. Could you explain this a little more?
Thank you for the question. I welcome also the audience and try to explain very shortly. VCL, it's the backbone of our ValueX project. VCL stands for Virtual Collaborative Learning.
Thank you, Professor Schoop. So you brought some slides with you. Could you explain to our participants and partners a little more what the VCL framework means?
Virtual Collaborative Learning explained in 5 minutes. What is the background idea? That background idea is nearly 20 years old. It refers to the 2001 European Council, the concrete future of objectives of education and training systems. Here it's written, the European education and training system has to encourage the personal growth of European citizens in three aspects: skills, adaptability, and mobility. Skills means that individuals get a foundation for their life and are enabled to work together in groups. They should by this stay or become adaptable, so get the ability to learn about and adjust to new situations while staying independent and respecting others. And the virtual mobility describes the skills required in today's international and multicultural society. Working and communicating with others across national boundaries and adapt to the challenges of a global economy. Having that in mind, the key elements of VCL already developed in 2001 are the follows. We talk about higher education. That's a formal setting. We have learning goals, which are addressed by examinations, giving grades and credits. It takes place completely online. It's covering both asynchronous and synchronous dimensions and supports the learning in mixed teams. It's a case study style learning with open scenarios and solutions, and our team learners are closely supervised by qualified e-tutors. The last point is situative learning. We build authentic cases. Project style collaboration takes place, and by aligning our stories, our cases in the learning environment to reality, we want to reduce inert knowledge in the transfer from knowledge learned at higher education institutions and their applicants in later work situations. Virtual collaborative learning is virtual. New communication channels, social software, platforms enable this. It is collaborative, working in learning in groups, benefiting from the experience of others. And learning is the main focus to acquire new knowledge, build up new competencies and experience in situative learning environments. The lower level of this chart, we see numerous VCL projects having taken place in everyday's teaching environments. So VCL is a very complex learning arrangement. We talk about four main design dimensions. We call them pivotal instruments, which ensure the quality and situativity in our VCL settings. realistic cases, authentic cases, and working tasks derived from these cases foster the situative learning. We rely on a collaborative technical platform, and we use Microsoft Teams and Office 365. Learning analytics and information visualization provide data and for building dashboards for supervisors and for learners, and give data for competitive situations. And last but not least, the professionalized pedagogical support concepts behind are visualized primarily to support personalized individual feedback and assessment of the teams, the students' teams, and the individuals inside the teams. And this is based on our e-tutors who have a specific qualification to supervise the teamwork and to moderate the team interaction processes. For more details on VCL, you might refer to our presentation on the DAED conference on virtual exchange. It's about borderless mobility between the European higher education area and regions beyond. On the left side of this slide, you see the publication referred to. We have tiny URLs which lead you to the article on the web and a presentation video on the web. And this is my short introduction to VCL.
So let's have a look at our Microsoft Teams instance. Today, our VCL, the participants are working on our platform and are supervised by qualified e-tutors. So let's have a look into the e-tutors channel. The e-tutors are moderating group work and are contact persons for the participants. Here you can see the stream and the interaction of the e-tutors. When you open the stream, you can see the information the people shared with each other. Here you can see the interaction of the e-tutors regarding a specific topic. Then you have also other options, like storing files in your channel, within your team, like class materials, like tasks, like videos or Word documents, and open them inside the software.
Is it possible at this stage that the team members can collaboratively work on their common documents?
Absolutely. When you open the document, other team members can join the document. You can even open it in your desktop app. It's totally an all-in-the-box solution. So you have the whole Office 365 range integrated into the Teams software.
This is a real example for situative learning, because what you're describing here, that is an everyday common collaborative workplace situation in the knowledge companies in our economy. So our students already have their learning processes included in an authentic functionality and environment. That's great.
Absolutely. And besides that, the collaborative work with files and posts in a streamline, like in social media, you also have more options. You can use an activity stream where you can see what people are talking, like the ones of our VCL. You can see the groups here, or even for the teamwork within our chair, we are using Teams.
This is fascinating. So it's a running learning or teaching project. So really taking place live while we are producing this short video clip. But how is this running virtual mobility project linked to the ValueX project?
Thank you for this question, Professor Schob. Our Albanian partners from the ValueX project are very engaged and have distributed a wave of pilot participants who have been integrated to observe the VCL concept and gain a first impressions and experience before they attend on this format for themselves. But Professor Schob, what can we expect the next days and weeks from the project?
Well, what is up? We have invited stakeholders and decision makers from Albanian universities and state agencies to an expert forum to build a common understanding of the targets of our ValueX project. We shall align targets, hold staff trainings in this environment, Microsoft Teams, and we will develop training material. The transfer of didactical design patterns is an overarching target of the project to empower Albanian universities to strengthen virtual mobility for students and academic staff, as well as international partnerships and internationalization at home.
Thank you for the detailed explanation. For more information, check out our website, valuex.eu.
Thank you very much for the chance to give an explanation to VCL, and we are looking forward to see all stakeholders online in the next days to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.